So we want to notice that we can utilize the power of products and quotient rules because we have this quantity raised to the negative third power. So that needs to be distributed to each part of the numerator as well as in the denominator. So if we were to rewrite this, we would have 2 to the negative third times an x. And remember, using the power rule of exponents, if you have an exponential expression that it's being raised to a power, you keep the same base but multiply the exponents together. So we have a negative 2 times a negative 3 and y to the negative third. Then in the denominator, we have x to the 5 times negative 3, again using that power rule for exponents, and y to the 4 times negative 3. Now, we want to simplify this further. So, in the numerator, we have a 2 to the negative 3 times x, and multiplying negative 2 times a negative 3, we get to the 6th, and y to the negative 3rd. And in the denominator, we're left with x to the negative 15th and y to the negative 12th. Now, notice that we have negative exponents left in this answer, which we want to make sure that in the final answer, all exponents are positive. So we need to look at each part of this expression that has negative exponents. And remember that we take the reciprocal of those and then make the exponents positive. And be careful, you want to make sure you're only doing this with the parts of the expression that have negative exponents. So as we move through the numerator, we have a 2 to the negative 3. So we want to take the reciprocal of that, meaning it moves from the numerator down to the denominator, and the exponent becomes positive. Now we have our x to the 6th term. And since x to the 6th does not have a negative exponent, it can stay where it is in the numerator. And then our y to the negative 3rd term, we want to take the reciprocal of that, so it moves to the denominator and the exponent becomes positive. Now we have, in the denominator, we have an x to the negative 15th power, so taking the reciprocal of that, that term moves to the numerator and the exponent becomes positive. And finally, the y to the negative 12th power, again we take the reciprocal and move it to the numerator and make the exponent positive. Now we need to make sure that we simplify this completely, and we notice that we have in the numerator an x to the 6th times an x to the 15th, and since they have like bases and are being multiplied together, we add those exponents together, so we have an x to the 21st power. And then going to the y, we notice we have a y term in both the numerator and the denominator. And so, using our quotient rule for exponents, we know that we can subtract the exponent in the denominator from the exponent in the numerator. So we have y to the 12 minus 3, which gives us y to the 9th power. And then our term that's left is 2 to the 3rd power, which really is 2 times 2 times 2, and that gives us 8. So we have 8 in the denominator. And our final answer is x to the 21st, y to the 9th, all over 8.